I would like to welcome you and thank you for being here today. Today is a day of celebration. Celebration of the academic progress that has been made during the year, celebration of social gains and friendships that have developed, and celebration and anticipation of what the future holds. To our fifth graders, I am so proud to be your principal and to have had the opportunity to be part of your elementary school experience. It's the people in a school that make it special. And at Pinebrook, you are those people, along with your teachers and the entire staff who are so incredibly proud of you. Throughout our program today, you'll be hearing a variety of inspirational quotes, and I wanted to share one about believing in yourself. Believe in yourself. You are braver than you think, more talented than you know, and capable of more than you imagine. We want you to carry this thought with you because we believe in you and are so excited for your future successes. School events and celebrations like this do not happen without lots of help. So before we officially get started, I want to thank and recognize the parent committee that's worked so hard to add to the success of today's events and the parade in particular. Deanna Schirmacher, Katie DePeace, Laura Caparella, Kristen Schugert, Amy Bella, Heather Wolf-Stimson, Kelly Strelick, Pam Pecorella, Nicole McEntee, Christy Keller, Christina DePasquale, and our entire PTSA. Our school community greatly benefits from the presence of volunteers who so willingly give up their time and talents. Thank you to the many volunteers who have supported this amazing group of students throughout their years at Pinebrook. We look forward to recognizing student accomplishments and successful completion of the elementary school experience. We trust that the experiences at Pinebrook have prepared you for your work in middle school and that you will continue to meet with great success. It has been a privilege to have each of you as members of the Pinebrook family. At this time, we will begin some of the recognition and additional celebration in our program. I invite Mrs. Valkovic up to the podium.
Thank you, Mrs. Boyle. I am Mrs. Valkovic, and I am going to be presenting the President's Educational Achievement Award. The President's Educational Achievement Award is given to students who have shown tremendous growth and achievement in school, or who show an unusual commitment to learning and improving academics. The recipients of this award for the 2020-2021 school year are Amelia Baker, Bailey Bianchi, Hannah Dill, Cameron Ferris, Ashley Feeney, Presley McCain, Louis Ferrari, Sierra Harrington, Braden Caves, Alexis Klimo, Olivia Lasher, Landry Mikulski, Haley Peer, Brandon Thomas, Gianna Tomaselli, Gavin Umbrino, and William Villegas. Congratulations to all fifth graders for this award. And next will be Mrs. Benham presenting the Presidential Educational Excellence Award. So the next award is the President's Educational Excellence Award. This award is presented to students who have made outstanding academic achievement in fourth and fifth grade in the core subjects and who demonstrate high motivation, initiative, and leadership. Congratulations to the following students: Taylor Ball, Juliana Burley, Alina Keisha, Lucas Caffarella, Grace Candelari, Colin Casarino, Brennan Coughlin, Gavin DePeace, Joseph DePasquale, Braden Disler, Jackson Doran, Aubrey Fox, Jolene Galloway, Kayla Goodfriend, Michael Keller, Martin Kent, Ethan Koselny, Kayla Lemke, Joseph Levitro, Maria Mantel, Anna Maurer, Emma Maurer, Adriana McEntee,
Brianna McEntee, Noah McMichael, Aaliyah Merlo, Milana Michelli, Thora Moore, Amina Mujicic, Gabriella Muley, Charles Nowakowski, Dante Pacheco, Nora Panic, Colton Pecorella, Connor Paulus, Ian Riley, Ariana Rodriguez, Sabari Sampson, Nathan Schirmacher, Charles Shannon, Christopher Shaw, Aniston Sugar, Zoe Smalley, Marcus Stimson, Lucas Strelick, Hannah Trumpkowski, Aaliyah Velasquez, Anthony Vella, Henry Walter, Madeline Wegman, Ella Woodruff, and Emma Zink. Congratulations.
The next award is the Elementary Student Board of Education Award. The image on the front of the Greece Central School District Elementary School Student Award is based on the design of the ring of the first graduating class of Olympia High School in 1961. The original district logo included the Lamp of Knowledge, the Wreath of Excellence, and the five rings as used by the International Olympic Committee. They represent intellectual, cultural, social, physical, and spiritual learning. The Greek temple signifies our historical linkage with ancient Greece. The two dates denote the division of the town of Greece into common schools districts in 1823 and the establishment of the Greece Central School District on November 1st, 1928. The reverse side of the medallion denotes our nation's symbol, a bald eagle, as well as the Lamp of Knowledge, the American flag, and the five Olympic rings. These symbols represent the basis for selection for this award: excellence in learning, citizenship, and cultural understanding. This award is presented on behalf of the Board of Education, administration, and staff.
Hi, I'm Ann McAdam, the school counselor. And before I read the list of recipients for this award, I would like to congratulate all of our fifth graders. It has been a great pleasure working with you, and we will miss you all. The recipients for this year's board awards are Juliana Burley, Alina Keisha, Lucas Caparella, Grace Candelari, Kayla Lemke, Thora Moore, Nora Panic, Ian Riley, Marcus Stimson, and Aaliyah Velasquez. Congratulations to all.
Hi, I'm Rita Huffer, and I would like to present the criteria for the Triple C Award. The New York State Triple C Award is presented by Attorney General Letitia James to a small number of students who have demonstrated the qualities of courage, character, and commitment. Whether succeeding in academic pursuits, participating in community service, displaying leadership skills, or overcoming personal obstacles, these students provide us with hope for a brighter future.
Hello, everybody, and congratulations, fifth graders. I am Kaylee Bennett, and I am proud to present one of the awards to Bella Rose Hernandez. Hi, Bella. Bella Rose has displayed courage, character, and commitment in her daily life, at home and in school, and has become a true inspiration to all who know her. Bella has shown courage many times in her life by persevering through many surgeries and reaching many milestones. Bella Rose lives her life to the fullest, sharing her amazing personality with everyone who knows her. She always tries her best, works very, very hard at everything she does, and has a personal commitment to achieving every task or goal set for her, and is truly an inspiration. She is kind, funny, and a good friend to all. She loves life and has a magnetic personality. To know Bella is to love her, and she brings a smile to all of us. So Bella, Bella Boo, we love you.
Congratulations.
Hello, everyone. I'm Miss Ojeda. Our next recipient of the Triple C Award goes to Sipbari Sampson. Sipbari is the true definition of courage, character, and commitment. Sip, you show courage each day by standing up for what you know in your heart is right. Your character shines in the way you treat others. Your commitment to making yourself the best you can possibly be is impressive. The book club you created in January and led for 5 months showed your amazing leadership skills. You hosted weekly meetings, kept everyone on task, and held the group members accountable in the most caring way possible. You gave everyone a voice and made it fun for those students who were part of this club. As a member of the orchestra, you showed not just leadership, but courage and perseverance through your commitment to practice, play your best, and be your best every day. You are an example, not just of an excellent student, but an excellent person. You embody what it means to say to ourselves, we can do hard things. We have all loved every minute of being your teacher. Congratulations, and continue to be an inspirational role model for others because you give us hope for a brighter future. Bravo, Sip.
I am Mr. Style, the art teacher. A reminder for our audience to please silence your cell phone. A little strange talking to a camera, but I'm going to go a little bit off the teleprompter for a second just to share a quick story about this next recipient. Just the other day, we were streaming a musical performance into our classrooms, and afterwards the credits came up, and this child's face appeared up on the screen, and my kindergarten class spontaneously started clapping for this individual. She volunteers in their classroom, and she is an amazing student. I will tell you right now, her nickname is M&M. I call her that because daily I ask her what type of day we're going to have in art, plain or peanut. She always chooses not the ordinary, but the extraordinary, because that's the type of student she is. Congratulations to Emma Zink for her courage, character, and commitment. Those are the attributes that Emma Zink has shown throughout her time here at Pinebrook, especially this year in fifth grade. She's always up to the challenge, thinks out every angle, and attacks her challenges with confidence. These are the skills that she has developed through hard work, determination, both at school and at home. She has learned who she is as a person and the strategies that will allow her to be successful. She has taught herself to be incredibly organized and is a wonderful big sister to Riley. She does all of this with a smile and an appreciation of the little things in life like family nights, homemade family dinners, and recipes. Hope I can be invited over someday after the pandemic. And of course, we have all loved being your teacher. Everyone in this audience who has had the opportunity to teach Emma, we are just grateful. We have the privilege of teaching you and so many amazing fifth graders. So I'd like to say we have all loved you, and we are looking forward to hearing about all of your accomplishments in the future. Congratulations to Emma Zink.
Hi, good morning, everyone. I'm Mrs. MD, and I'm going to present the criteria for the Comptroller's Award. The New York State Comptroller's Achievement Award is presented each year to a student who has excelled academically and has also shown leadership potential by volunteering his or her time to serve the school or community. Mr. Miscadre will now present this award.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Mr. Miscadre. This year, our recipient of the New York State Comptroller's Achievement Award is presented to Jackson Doran. Jackson, you embody everything this award stands for. You stand for high expectations. Sorry, you set high expectations for yourself and give 110% effort every day, which is why you excel both academically and socially. Your leadership qualities shine in and out of the classroom. You go above and beyond each day and persevere through any difficult task. There's no challenge you won't take on. As your PE teacher, it hasn't gone unnoticed that you have displayed these traits since a young age. Continue to always lead in your humble way, and kids will continue to follow you. Thank you for always being a superior role model for your peers. Congratulations, Jackson, on this prestigious award.
Good morning and congratulations, everybody. My name is Christina Giuliano. This is the Melinda Sufra Award. This award was established in memory of Pine Brook Lunch Monitor and parent, Mrs. Melinda Sufra. Mrs. Sufra exemplified the qualities of kindness, caring, and respect. She always looked for and found the positive in each person. Not only did she possess these qualities, but she instilled them in those whose lives she touched. The Melinda Sufra Memorial Award is being presented to a student who exemplifies these qualities. The selected students will have their names on a plaque that will be displayed in the front hallway. This award is one of the most touching recognitions for the depth it holds and the honor from one extraordinary heart to another. A remarkable child who strives to love, understand everyone, to spread compassion with her acts of kindness, and who chooses to view others and this world with a heart full of empathy and acceptance. Congratulations to Hannah Dill, one of the recipients of the Melinda Sufra Award. Hannah knows the importance of having an impact on someone's life and sharing her gifts. Kindness, love, and hope. All of these Hannah shares with her peers on a daily basis, educators and family. Her intention to brighten someone's day and to ensure the joy conquers any negativity. She focuses on gratitude, she chooses happiness, and she knows one of her greatest purposes is to remind others that they are important and loved. All of us who have taught Hannah are so pleased to honor her with the incredible heart and the legacy she leaves behind. So touching lives in the very best way. Congratulations, Hannah.
I'm Rhonda Allen, I'm the band director, and I'm very delighted to tell you about the next recipient of this award. I have been very lucky to work with her for 2 years. The award also is going to Aaliyah Velasquez. Aaliyah exemplifies the kindness, caring, and respect that this award calls out. She's a quiet leader in the classroom who leads by example and joins groups of students together with her acceptance. She works extremely hard to make others feel welcome and included, and has been an integral part of the classroom community. It's our honor to have Aaliyah as a Melinda Sufra Award recipient this year. Congratulations, Aaliyah.
And now it's time for our presentation. Now it's time for our presentation of our fifth grade classes. My message to this awesome group of fifth graders is one that my father taught me at a young age and one you've heard me say all year, which is to surround yourself with good people. Surround yourself with people that push you to do and be better. Friends that make you laugh, but also help you when you are in need. Stick with those who genuinely care, not just the ones who say it, but the ones who show it. People who encourage you to chase after your dreams and then applaud your victories. Those are the friends you want to have in your life. And now, presenting Mrs. Benham's fifth grade class of 2021. Thank you.
So I am Miss Bennett, and I am the lucky teacher who gets to teach the 1213 program here at Pine Brook. This year, my only fifth grader is Bella Rose Hernandez, and I'm going to try really hard not to cry. Bella, my wish for you is that you shine your light and let the whole world see. Being your teacher has been one of my life's best gifts. You are such a beautiful gift, and we have all been in awe of your hard work, positive attitude, and perseverance. I have loved watching you bloom over the past 3 years, coming out of your shell more and more and sharing your amazing spirit with us. You are so loved, and you have an amazing family. Your Pine Brook family is always rooting for you and so, so proud of you. And we will be with you as you continue on your next journey. I hope you know how much your teachers love you here at Pine Brook. And it is now my honor to present Ms. Bella Rose as a 1213 fifth grade graduate.
Hi everyone, I'm Mrs. Gil Smith. I have had the pleasure of teaching your children expedition learning this year. And my little A12 family, I want to say I'm very proud of all of you, and it has been an absolute pleasure teaching you and helping you through this incredible year that we've made the best of. A quote that I've shared with all of our children this year that's very near and dear to my heart is one by Jackie Robinson. And we talk often about this, especially during this time and moving into middle school, but the legacy we're leaving behind and the impact that we've had. So my quote is by Jackie Robinson. A life is not important except in the impact that it has on other lives. It is my hope that wisdom, courage, and resilience, love as well, has developed in your hearts from all that you've endured, overcome, and learned this past year. Remember that above all, what is most important is the impact that you can have on someone else's life. Have empathy for others, show compassion, stand up for what's right, and love with all your hearts. At this time, I would like to present my class, A12.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Belkovic, here to present my class. And as you know, and I've talked about this as well with all the classes, that I have climbed many mountains in my day, around 50 at least. And I just have to say from my heart, my quote is, the best view comes after the hardest climb. In life, you will come across challenges. And as we've all spoke about this year, we've had a lot of challenges. And they make you who you are. Those challenges make you who you are. When you are at the hardest part of that climb, the hardest part in your life, just know that the best is on the other side. It will be worth that hard work that you are put through. It makes you who you are today. Thank you, boys and girls. Thank you, everybody, for making this year so special for all of us. And now I present my class, A10. fifth grade, 2021. Thank you very much.
This group of amazing students, the Pine Brook fifth grade class of 2021, has accomplished so much this year and throughout their elementary school experience. To our parents and families, thank you again for your ongoing support. To our teachers and staff, thank you for your tireless efforts with students. A special thank you to our special area teachers who are here today and have had the privilege of working with students over multiple years. To our fifth grade teachers who put in a tremendous amount of work planning and facilitating today's program, and their ongoing care and work with all of you this year. A shout out to the many other teachers, counselors, and staff who have worked with and supported this amazing class. Thank you again to all members of the Moving Up Committee. To our fifth graders, again, we are so proud of you and so confident that you are well prepared for middle school. We're excited for you and for the opportunities that the future holds. At Pine Brook, we say once a part of Pine Brook, always a part of Pine Brook. We hope that you will visit and perhaps do some volunteer work with us in middle or high school. And we'll, of course, look forward to celebrating you again when you come back as high school seniors in your caps and gowns. Best wishes to each and every one of you. You have made us proud and we believe in you. As a reminder to students and families, our parade, our drive-through parade will begin at 12:30 today and will take place by class. Mrs. Benham's class, 12:30 to 12:50. Mrs. Keel Smith and Ms. Bennett's classes, 12:50 to 1:20. Mr. Thornton and Mr. Fowler's classes, 1:20 to 1:40. And Mrs. Valkovic's class, 1:40 to 2:00. Just a reminder about the route for the parade. We ask that cars enter in the east driveway, just like morning arrival and afternoon dismissal. The line of cars will circle the back lot and then pull in at the end to our bus loop in front of the school. So thank you again for joining us today. And we look forward, we apparently have one other person that needs to say something, but thank you for joining us today, and we look forward to seeing all of you this afternoon for continued celebration.
So as we've learned this year, the good news about technology is that as soon as something goes wrong, you can send us messages on Google Classroom saying that you couldn't hear us and our class didn't get presented. So we're back.
We taught you well. Thank you.
Good job using your resources.
So as I'll say again, and you didn't hear us the first time, our quote for you guys comes from the great Walt Disney. All our dreams can come true if you have the courage to pursue them. So our wish for you is that you remember all the courage that you had this year to overcome your obstacles. Hybrid learning, virtual learning, masks, difficulties, and moving up ceremonies. But through your courageous work, you worked together and you overcame.
We enjoyed getting to know each of you personally, especially when you shared your thoughts and feelings and dreams with us. We're proud of all the work that you've done. We're proud to be your teachers this year, and we look forward to hearing of all the good things that you've done in middle school and beyond. Now we will present our actual class, the kids that we taught for a little while, Mr. Thornton and Mr. Fowler's fifth grade class.
Thank you again, and we look forward to seeing everyone this afternoon for the parade.